Hey folks. So after I watched Buckaroo Banzai, I started thinking about another movie that we used to watch a lot. It was in rotation pretty heavily for a while there. And I realized, you know, I bet this is another movie you've never heard of. So I mentioned it to Noferblatz, and he thought, well, let's go ahead and put it in and watch it, and that way I can do a review for you, because it'll be fresh in my mind. And so that's what we did. The movie is Chud. Here we go. I know that this glare on the box art. C-H-U-D, and then it's a little subtitle. Cannibalistic Humanoid Underground Dwellers. Technically, this is a horror film. And I say technically because to me it's really more comedy than a horror film. They meant it to be serious, but this is definitely low budget. I'm not a horror film fan. I have never watched any of the Friday the 13th movies, Halloween movies, the Saw movies. I don't like the slasher movies. It's just not my cup of tea. Old classic horror, you know, old werewolf, vampire, Frankenstein kind of movies from way back, I like those, not these. But this movie, to me, is more funny. It's not scary. What gore there is, and there's mangled body parts and things, it's just goofy looking. It doesn't look real in the slightest. And you don't have the scare tactics that modern day horror films like to do to startle you. So I can watch this and not be bothered by it. The cast of this movie is actually quite impressive when you think about it. Again, low budget movie. But a lot of the people in this movie you're going to recognize. They've gone on to have very prolific careers, in particular in television, but they've had amazing careers. Now, the two main leads in this, played by John Hurd and Daniel Stern. Those two actors were fairly well established by the time this came out. This came out in 1984. I mean, they weren't huge stars, but they had quite a few things under their belts by the time they got these parts. The other major lead, an actor named Christopher Curry, did go on to do a bunch of TV, but this was a little early in his career. The female lead in this, and I wrote all the, I had to write these names down because there's just too many. I don't know how she pronounces her last name, so I apologize. It's Kim Greist or Greist. I'm not sure how it's pronounced. You will recognize her probably because she's done a lot since Chud, but this was her very first movie. And like I said, she's the female lead in it. And then there's going to be some other people with little bit parts because it was fairly early in their careers, but you, I'm sure, will recognize, like John Goodman. I know you know who that is. In the latter half of the movie, there's a scene where these two police officers walk into a diner, and the two police officers are played by John Goodman and Jay Thomas, both great comedians. And both have had quite wonderful careers since this, but this was fairly early in both of their careers. There's a bit part played by Patricia Richardson. I know you know who that is, but this was very early in her career. Another bit part, Ray Baker. You may not recognize his name, but if you saw him, you would recognize him. And John Polito, another name that you might not recognize, but if you saw him, you'd know him because he's done a ton since this movie. But fairly early in the careers of all those people. So, what is Chud all about? I don't want to give you the whole entire story because then you won't watch it. But basically, there's something living in the sewers underneath New York City. And it's been preying on the homeless people who live down there. And when it started running out of homeless fodder to eat, the things that were living down there have decided to come to the surface, and they're taking people walking down the street and whatnot, and they eat them. I mean, it's a food source for them. Daniel Stern plays a character named AJ who runs a soup kitchen, so he caters to the homeless, and he started noticing a lot of his patrons going missing, and they all happened to be ones who were living underground in the sewers and in the subway area. John Hurd plays a photographer who has taken pictures of the homeless people and has befriended them, and that's how he gets pulled into the story. Christopher Curry plays a police captain whose own wife has gone missing in this area, and every time any other person goes missing, he's investigating it because he's trying to figure out what happened to his wife. the bulk of the movie is basically a case of a government trying to cover its tracks for doing something bad. There's a fellow who represents the Nuclear Regulatory Commission, NRC. He's really the big bad guy in all of this, trying to cover up what's really been going on in the sewers, as well as trying to deal with these creatures that are attacking and killing people and pets and things. So everything works out in the end, I'll tell you that much. But it's just a lot of goofiness. There's a particular character whose name is Val, played by a fellow called Graham Beckel, and he does a great job of playing someone who is just virtually psychotic. He's been underground for too long. He's one of the homeless that live in the sewers. He's seen what's going on down there, and he has a couple of parts, just two little parts in the movie, and he steals the show with his performance. So it's worth watching it just for seeing Beckel play this character. And of course, I like Daniel Stern. He's a lot of fun. He's not playing it as a comedy. I mean, what you know Daniel Stern for these days, of course, the Home Alone movie, and a lot of other stuff. He tends to play comedic roles, but he's playing a serious role. Again, this was not meant to be a comedy. I just consider it one because it's so low budget, and it's so cheesy in the effects, the creature, and things like that. So if you want something that's just goofy fun, you know, again, not meant to be a comedy, but you can't help see the humor in it, then check out CHUD, Cannibalistic Humanoid Underground Dwellers. Oh, by the way, I should point out one more thing. CHUD has a separate meaning. It's not just that. But you have to watch the movie to find out what the second meaning is. That's all for this week. Come back and see me.
See ya.